Welcome back, YouTube. Thank you all for checking in with the Cash Couple. This is Mr. Suave99, one half of the Cash Couple, and today we're back with a finance dictionary episode. Today's finance dictionary episode is going to be on APR, and I'm going to explain to you all what APR is, how it relates to your finances and making and managing money, and just give you guys a little brief overview of it. If you like this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel, and we're gonna go ahead and get into it. So APR is annual percentage rate. Part of speech for it, it's a noun. Sometimes you may also hear this called interest rate. However, the difference between an APR and an interest rate is your APR may also include other fees that are like brokerage fees or other fees from the loan. So the APR is just that percentage that includes all of your fees. What are some pros of the APR? You know, one of the biggest pros with APR, even when it's variable interest, is your knowledge of the rate. When you sign up for a loan or a credit card or anything like that, they make sure that they disclose to you your APR. It's part of that whole process in getting any loan, so that you know what you're getting into. You know what that rate is. You can multiply it out and find out, you know, what you're actually being charged throughout the duration of that loan to keep it, whether or not you're paying it off fast or not. You know, the next thing that's good about the APR is your knowledge of your loan terms. If you really know about APR and you're aware of what it is, then you're more apt to look for it and look for it in your loan terms and see what you're actually being charged over the duration of that loan to keep it. And you're less likely to enter into bad financial situations because you have the knowledge of what APR is and how it affects you and your loans. Some of the cons of APR is, again, it may include additional fees. You know, it's a variable interest rate and that APR may change a little bit, or there's other fees that are associated with that loan that they include into the APR. The other thing with APR is that it affects the cost of whatever you're buying. So whenever you buy something and you buy it on credit and there is an APR, you have to take that into consideration and calculate it, because you just don't want that to be something that will negatively affect you in the long run, where you thought you were paying this amount and it turns out that you're paying exponentially more because of that APR. With that being said, thank you all for watching. Again, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Leave any comments below for any future financial terms you may want for us to review. In addition to any questions or concerns that you have going forward. Thank you all for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.